Okay, that's a tricky one. Selecting a research discipline area. You have to ask yourself, what do you really enjoy doing? Think about during your university years. What did you enjoy the most? What was the most interesting project that you did it yourself? And despite of what kind of mark you got, did you really enjoy doing it? When you choose your research, and therefore academic career, you should always choose whatever makes you happy. And that is a bit of an interesting point. So when you are a student and you have to do your research project on the third year or fourth year or at the master's level, it's good if you think about it very, very carefully, because that may be the first research project that you do yourself. So what I advise is, once you are a undergraduate student, you think very carefully what kind of project you want to do and in which area is that, and also talk to your supervisors, the potential supervisors, to give you more information. So definitely you want to do something that you're interested in, something that you really enjoy, and you spend your time having a good time doing it. Otherwise you will not do it well. So make sure that what you choose is of your great interest and ideally something that you would like to continue for the next years, even after the university. It is very good to actually talk to other people and see what they think about that project and about the idea. It's also good to get some like people outside your field and very unbiased people who can give you a really honest opinion about the project. Of course, you will talk to the potential supervisor as well as other tutors that you may have at the university and ask them for an idea of the project, whether it is good, whether it is within the disciplines that are quite supported nowadays from the market, from the industry, and also seek for specific advices from those tutors for pursuing and contacting that project. At the same time, you can speak to professional mentors that you may have through the professional institutions that, as I said in the previous video, is actually good to register very early on in your studies. So talk to these people and ask them about the topic, about the idea, and what would have been a good way of carrying out that research and what would have been a very good outcome out of it. So don't take it all on yourself. Speak to people. Try to understand the bigger picture. What is the impact of the project? What can be done during your studies? And what is likely to be the outcome if you continue that later on in your research career? By doing this work at that very early on stage, you will realize that if you then select to become a researcher, so you continue your research studies, you do a PhD, and then you want to do a postdoc, then you will see that all that information that you've started doing very early on was really useful. Of course, it is important to know that a PhD itself is not only about the research. A PhD is about you developing some skills throughout doing research. So developing a new set of skills that you did not develop during your undergraduate and postgraduate degrees. These skills can be the way that you write down the hypothesis of your idea and what is the actual problem, what is the methodology and the approach to tackle that problem and come up with tangible solutions, how you articulate the objective data and interpretation, and how you communicate to the people and the greater audience of the novelty that you developed, you discovered during your research studies. So these kind of skills, they are the core of a PhD, and this is what every PhD student actually should gain during those studies. It's not only about working on a particular theme, on a particular topic, and come up with a few publications that may be led by the supervisor, but it's actually getting all that experience during the PhD, things that you can transfer after to your academic or non-academic work. A good way to choose what kind of discipline and theme you would like to work on is also the REF, the Research Exercise Framework, which is published every few years, and it's also good to see what kind of themes are within that REF and where the industry is going, where the academia is going, what are the hot topics, the interesting topics. So having read that, it will definitely help you a lot to decide what kind of discipline you want to work in. After that, try to assess what is likely to happen in the next few years. Maybe a decade is a kind of an indicative period where you can predict what is going to happen. And based on that, think about the research skills that you need to develop during a PhD or your research. Let me also say that it doesn't mean that the actual topic of your research will be the one that you carry over in your research or academic career. So think about again how you develop those skills that make you suitable for other topics as well. Another way to find what kind of themes and disciplines and research areas, focus areas are of great importance today and for the next few years is to look at what is the funding. So what sort of funding is available and what kind of calls, specific calls within funding or bodies, and actually see who is getting funded. In this way, you will realize where the research is going, and that will give you a very good idea what kind of project and discipline you would like to select. You can also do that by looking at the papers that they get published, but there are so many papers out there, so perhaps it will be a bit difficult to find out what is the trend. But of course, if you're following some key researchers who are leading research in their themes, then you can see what are the most recent papers they published, and from that get an idea of where the research is going. Another thing that you would like to think from the very early stage is whether you would like to work in smaller or bigger groups, whether you would like to be the one who's doing something new and people are following you, or to join a successful bigger group at a particular university somewhere in the world. So again, working more independently or working within a group is something that you should think about. Bear in mind that not all great research is done by large groups. There are excellent outcomes from very small groups. In some cases, they're leading to spin-off companies and then much bigger startups and very big companies. There are Nobelists who are maybe themselves or two, three people working together, and they come up with something new. It's not absolutely necessary that you're working in a much bigger group unless you want to use specific facilities and knowledge generated over the years. So these were some random thoughts about selecting your research career from the very early on stage, since you are a student at the university, to just the point that you've graduated from your degree and you're thinking about what kind of PhD you would like to do. So hopefully those kind of tips will be useful to undergraduate as well as postgraduate students and young researchers who are just starting their journey to research world. And hopefully they're useful. If you do find them useful, please consider subscribing to the channel and hit the like button so more students can actually see those videos. With that said, bye bye.